Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We continue our Lenten journey as we near the triumphant entry of Jesus into the city of his death. So let us then be found ready and worthy as we ask for the forgiveness of our sins.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. I hear the whisperings of many, terror on every side. Denounce, let us denounce him. All those who were my friends are on the watch for any misstep of mine. Perhaps he will be trapped, then we can prevail and take our vengeance on him. But the Lord is with me, like a mighty champion. My persecutors will stumble, they will not triumph. In their failure, they will be put to utter shame, to lasting, unforgivable confusion. O Lord of hosts, you who test the just, who probe mind and heart, let me witness the visit you take on them. For to you I have entrusted my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord. For he has rescued the life of the poor from the power of the wicked. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
I love you, O Lord, my strength, O Lord, my rock, my fortress, my deliverer.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
My God, may rock of refuge, my shield, the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. Praise be the Lord, I exclaim. And I am safe from my enemies.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
The breakers of death surge round about me. The destroying floods overwhelm me. The cords of the netherworld enmesh me. The snares of death overtook me.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord and cried out to my God. From his temple, he heard my voice, and my cry to him reached his ears.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
By the scriptures becoming clearer and clearer that we are arriving to the Holy Week time that always leads us to the city of Jerusalem, accompanies Jesus in the final week of his life, and there on Holy Thursday after the meal with his disciples, the Passover celebration completed, he goes into the garden to pray. And then to allow his arrest. So the scriptures are bringing more and more reason into the hearts of his persecutors and eventually his executioners to have something against him. And today, as the crowd picks up stones to throw at Jesus as the Jews are acting on what they feel as the punishment of the law should come on Jesus, he even puts those words into his mouth, "I am the Son of God," and then shows the power of the works that he has been able to bring to the earth to display the presence of the kingdom of God in his 3 years of adult ministry and the formation of his church. But eventually, he will then hand himself over. So today there are moments when he slips away, when they are trying to stone him, when they are trying to trip him up in what he's saying, and when they are calling for his death. It is really the isolation of the Son of God that we're experiencing, that he is alone. Eventually in that garden he will pray, "Not my will, Father, but yours be done." Because united with the human family taking on our flesh, he is feeling more and more the isolation that is part of the suffering of the Son of Man. In fact, in our time now where we are called to pray in our homes, when we are called to not gather as families around the table of celebration, when the circumstance of the coronavirus allows us to feel that isolation of Jesus, our union with him is made stronger. Bishop Callahan recently called us to consider joining with him and the diocese for the celebration of the Triduum, Holy Thursday, Good Friday, Holy Saturday, and the diocesan website has that link for us to join with him around the cathedral church, where the bishop, as the representative of Christ in our midst, then surrounded by his priests, surrounded by their people, is a vision of that union that we have with Christ. This year will be then not a visual union, but I encourage you to then join him in the Triduum celebrations and to participate in that moment when Christ gives himself to us, that moment that is celebrated and remembered in a particular way every time we offer the Mass, when we receive him, body, blood, soul, and divinity in the Eucharist. When the people join Jesus, even in his isolation, as he carried his cross alone, as he, in his lifeless body, was buried in the tomb and the stone rolled into place, he was always one with the Father, forever united in their divine communion of life by the power of the Holy Spirit. So let us, in our journey entering into the city of Jerusalem, suffering with him and anticipating the resurrection, find oneness with each other in our common prayer, in our homes, and in our love for one another. Raising our needs and petitions to our Heavenly Father, we pray that he hear and answer our call. We pray for the universal church. May our hearts rejoice in our unity with Christ our Savior by the will of our Heavenly Father. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the world in the common bond we have now. May our fears together be relieved because we are turning to God our Creator and because we trust in his loving plan for us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for governments around the world, our politicians, that their decisions might be marked by the wisdom of the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the sick, the sorrowful, the suffering, especially those affected by coronavirus. May they be restored in body, mind, and soul. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have gone before us in faith. Remember especially Frank and Anna Marchini. May they who sleep in the peace of Christ rise to praise him forever in the glory of heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we ask that you hear the prayers we have raised and answer them in your wisdom and love. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. May the unfailing protection of the sacrifice we have received never leave us, O Lord, and may it always drive far from us all that would do us harm. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
For the church and for the world, together we pray. Saint Michael the Archangel,
defend us in battle.
Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.